Here's an interesting one. I'm in the back panel of my DianeHockman.com.
Would you follow a proven system if it guaranteed you financial freedom?
Where's that coming from? It's probably coming from this goofy site. Even better. Let me shut this sucker down and then I'll show you what I'm talking about here. Guys, I'm at the back panel of my WordPress blog, DianeHockman.com, and I'm going over the comments. And this particular comment, and I'm not afraid for you to see it, Carrie, has been posted on my blog about, I don't know, 5 times. And so either they're giving these comments out to lots of people and the people are running around copying and pasting the comments, which, you know, is never gonna get you where you want to go. Or it's one person that's written one comment and they're running around putting it all over blogs all over town, hoping to get some traffic to their site. In fact, that was just their site that popped up with a little talking head on it. Guys, let's talk about social media, the power of social media and the beauty of social media. You know, back before social media, what we had was websites, and they were static, and they were put up by the owners, and back then, you know, it wasn't like everybody could use HTML and everything back then. Only specialized people knew how to put them up, and the website said whatever the owners wanted them to say. And then this magical new form came about called the blog. And on the blog, the owners of the sites were able to manipulate them easily. This is before WordPress and everything else, guys. And the owners of the blogs were able to manipulate them easily. And these sites became extremely powerful. This is the beginning of social media. And in fact, in Washington, bloggers were, you know, shaping policy and getting news out real quick. And the Huffington Post and all this other stuff started going on. It was very exciting, and then it trickled down into the home business industry and lots of, you know, regular people, and a lot of you guys have seen the movie Julie and Julia, you know, blog about Julia Child, and they became very predominant, and they're very authentic, very real, and very quick. Somebody sees something and they're able to go and write or speak about it immediately. So fast forward to 2010, here's little Diane, housewife, home business owner, and she has her blog. And she's able to write and speak on things that she sees and feels, and it's absolutely remarkable for all of us. But there's always people that want to beat the system, and they misuse the power of social media. And what happens is it destroys it for so many people. It's a shame, and all I got to do is put up a tweet deck real quick, and you know, I'm not even going to read them, but most of the stuff I get on TweetDeck is just a bunch of pitches and spam instead of people actually communicating. So when somebody does this type of stuff and goes around and puts stuff on blogs, and I love the way that it's like carefully disguised so that it doesn't look like spam because it's this whole big story, but if you've posted it on 4 million blogs over and over and it's absolutely the same because it's copied and pasted, it is spam, guys. Here's how to use blogs of your own and blog comments in a wonderful way. Because I want to show you, let's go over to a great blog in this industry, in our home business industry. I don't want to go there, I want to go to Jason's site. My wonderful cartoon buddy, Jason Better. Guys, Jason's got, and by the way, Jason is a, you'll see it come up. Why is it taking so long? Jason is this wonderful little cartoon guy, and he's the, guy from Better Networker, and he's got a great blog, and he writes great stuff about all kinds of topics. So here's what you do. This guy's got a rapidly followed blog. He's got lots of traffic, lots of people. You read a post. If you genuinely have something to say, get down to the bottom of the whole thing. Go read through the post. If you genuinely have something to say that's relevant, you can, ta-da, leave a comment. Oh, this is an opt-in. Hang on, let's find out where you comment. I guess you can leave a comment at the bottom of all the comments, okay? And you say something relevant to what Jason just wrote. And when you do that, other people in your industry are reading your comments, they're seeing if they agree with you, they disagree with you. And the cool part is that where your name is, let me show you on someone. Here's Volker. If you click on his thing, it's gonna take you to his site, okay? Scroll up. So if you write something cool, here's George. George owns That MLMB, another major blog in the industry. So if you click on George's name, it's going to take you over to his site. So if you write something relevant, somebody sees it, they go, this guy or girl has got it going on. The next thing you know, they're clicking and they're sniffing you out and they're checking you out. And it's a great way to get traffic. It's a great way to meet your colleagues. It's wonderful. When people spam, which is crummy, it ruins things for everybody. But then what's worse is when people try to disguise their spam, and all they're doing is going to somebody's blog and putting stuff for their own benefit. That's when it gets really, really yucky. You know, you come over here, George puts up all this incredible content to help us all and all kinds of stuff. And yeah, George is here to make money and make a living, as he should. Good for him. But when, if I were to come here and just put junk just for my benefit or trying to attract people just to me, that's when social media gets perverted. Now, don't get all wigged out about the word perverted. We're not talking in that kind of way. Perverted means messed up. I should look up the definition, but off skew. Guys, when you're working on your blog and you're working with commenting on other people's blogs, you know, use professionalism. Go out there, comment, add to the dialogue, add to the conversation. That's what social media is about. That's what attraction marketing is about. Your post on one of Jason or George's, your response to one of Jason or George's posts very well could get a person really attracted to you. The next thing you know, they're calling you up and they're wanting to join you. You're running around and spamming for the sake of traffic. And I'm not saying you do it. I'm just talking about people doing it in general. Or hiring an assistant to run around and paste the same comment all over the place. I see it on YouTube constantly. There's one guy, I get the same exact comment on every video I've ever done, and I delete him, and then he's back again. It's just like the rounds. He has no interest in knowing anybody. He has no interest in building relationships. He just wants to slap his link on my videos. And it's like really crummy. So think about it, guys. Be a pro. Walk around and be regal and comment and add to the dialogue and get to know people. And you'll find it's that simple to get people attracted to you. Hey guys, it's Diane Hockman. My site again is over at dianehockman.com. Come visit, hang out, and hey, leave me a comment. We'll see you later.